I was kind of living a life of a princess. We all Nepali people regard her, even worship her as a goddess. We regard her as the protector of the nation, and her duty is to bless the kingdom and the highest head of the states. I could feel the difference when I wore the Kumari makeup on and when I was in the full ornaments and when I had to sit on my special throne, the chair. I used to feel that, you know, I was superior to others, or I should not speak to anyone. It automatically comes. Whatever my wishes were, everything, all the demands were fulfilled, and I never missed anything from outside. One day, suddenly, I started crying continuously for 4 days, and that was for no reason at all. My mother tried to console me with all the gifts, you know, with candies and whatever possible. I did not stop crying, and even the priest and everyone who saw the Kumari crying had forecasted that, okay, this is going to mean some really bad omen to the country. And on the 4th day, I heard that the king and his entire family has been, you know, killed by someone at the royal massacre that happened. So that was something very unexplainable, and a biggest thing that happened to me as a Kumari. There are a lot of myths that especially the media people tell, that Kumaris are, you know, secluded within the four walls of the palace. They should not smile. They do not have their own life, and it's short of child abuse or something like that. But then it's just a half side of the story that is being shown to the world outside. Only during certain hours when she sits on that throne in a special room where she's not allowed to show the emotions. But when she comes out of that room, she's just as other normal girl. Her friends can come in and play with her, and she can watch movies, play, laugh, dance, and everything that she wants to do. My mom knew that she cannot be a Kumari forever, so she basically started to look for a teacher, a private teacher who could come and, you know, take classes to the Kumari inside the house itself. So that's how I started, you know, studying, like, from basic mathematics, science, to language and everything. For 10 years as a goddess, I had one kind of lifestyle, and the next day you have to be normal, and you don't know how being normal is like. So it was kind of all of a sudden change that happened. So from, you know, walking to bargaining in shops and switching from a private tutor to, you know, a class where there are 40 other students of my age, it was kind of all of a sudden change, and I was not sure would I be able to, you know, cope up with all these things, and would I be able to adjust into that. What I am today is because of what I learned from the experience being a Kumari, and also from what I am, you know, living the life, the normal life now. I think I was really blessed.